What's up guys, Hugh James here. Today we're back again, and in this video we're playing some top lane Ylva. So I thought I'd go for a utility build in the top lane. I've seen some people pull it off, so I thought I'd give it a shot. But today we actually have a special video. We're playing against myself, and we'll see if I can beat myself. Because apparently I'm also the Sven, so... see if we can outplay myself. We shall see. Okay, so from the looks of it, we're probably gonna be laning against Kinetic or Vox. Let's see if we can catch him off guard at level 1. Wait, we can win this trade. See if we could force a flask at least. Ooh, Grumshaw's behind me. Not gonna stop this recall? Nice. Wait, he doesn't have flask. Can get him? Okay, there. That was good. That was a good rotate for my team too. I think Grumshaw came from the riverside. It's a bit unusual, but that was good for my team to follow me down. Definitely helped me get the kill. But yeah, the reason why Ylva can go for these trades at level 1 is because with your B ability, you have your extra attack speed and extra damage too, so that makes it so you can outtrade pretty much like any weapon pair bot laner at level 1. And especially a Vox too. Vox is relatively weak at level 1 inside of these fights, so I definitely don't recommend walking up towards the bush near the Ghostfang or Blacklaw pit, or going up that far, because you can easily get caught off guard like that. And if you fall behind early, that makes it so much harder to farm up and stay even.
You can't hide. I have sonic hearing.
Okay, we'll see though. I've never played this build personally. I've always gone weapon pair Ylva, but thought I'd just change things up today. Try this out. But yeah, some people play this in the top lane before, since apparently it's really good at trading with weapon pair carries, so thought I'd try it out. Because you got your tank, plus the burst from your A and B combo, the natural damage is just really high. The base damage is high, so that makes it so you don't even really need too much weapon power or CP or damage items. Okay, it's a little bit of a struggle to farm the... some people do start off with the weapon blade. These Vox bounces are super obnoxious. I can't get an engage onto him because he's just gonna A away if I try and charge up. So I'll just farm up right now. Okay, so let's see. Unless we can land our burst, there isn't too much we could do right now. Once I get my Storm Crown, then I could start playing more aggressive. Unless I can like catch him outside of a bush or somewhere. But yeah, like in a lane like this, there's no way I'm gonna be able to land an A ability. Yeah, they can just keep on disengaging. Yeah, there's no way that's gonna land. Just get the minion. Or not. Oh yeah, some people like to start with the weapon blade, actually. I just realized that. That was why people started with the weapon blade and book on utility Ylva still, because CSing is kind of a pain. Okay, the dodge is rotating. I can go for this engage here. I still have flask. Can you heal me? Nice. Can we get this kill? Oh, can the burn get him? No, I did not. That's unfortunate. Dang. Yeah, see, with the good map awareness, it's much easier to time ganks with junglers and rotates.
Bears can track a smell from 32 clicks, so please take a shower.
Okay, let's have their healers up. Nice, we can take this. Grumshaw's bot side, so I'm not too worried about anybody ganking. Is this... oh, I thought the Vox was going to come this way. That's why I backed off on the other side. Nash trying to drop the aggro. Is he... okay, he's not coming for this. He has a cam in here, I know. Let's see, okay, that's a... alright trade. But yeah, see, right now my basic attacks don't really do too much. I think they know I'm in here. Yep, they know. Oh, wait, they're just out of range. That looked like that was gonna be in range. Thought I was gonna get that one off. Okay, that's fun though. So we can zone him out from this farm. Okay, can we get this kill? Nice, that was a good slope. No, they're still out of range. Oh, Vox is so noxious. Vox is probably actually pretty good into Ylva because you have so much mobility with your A. Makes it hard to land the combos. I was thinking I would have enough time to get the A ability off because I knew Adagio was going to run in there and slow him. So I was thinking that with the slow from Adagio, they wouldn't be able to get away. But that did not work out. Okay, we'll go and get a shop in. Okay, now that I got my Stormcrown, I should be able to do more in trades. Because at least now I can play around my Stormcrown proc. So I have a bit more damage, even if I don't land my combo. I want to see if he walks onto that trap. I'm going to try and let the wave push in a little bit. See if he comes this way. If he goes for this last hit, he should be right on top of the trap. Okay. There's the flask and ult. Let's see if we can pressure this. If I can get one more like burst on him, I think I should be able to get him. I want to get my Stormcrown proc onto him. Nice. Oh wait, I should have just autoed one more time. Wait, I'm trolling. Oh wait, I'm dead. Okay, that's unfortunate. I totally had that there. I was worried I was gonna die there. I should not. I should have just gone for that. Yeah, because I totally had it. Kind of overestimated my damage. Yeah, from the looks of it, auto attacks are not exactly doing much at all. If I would have gone weapon paired this match, I think I'd be snowballing so much more. Looks like this Finn is having a good time being me. Okay, we'll see though. Because I know that utility Ylva's, the power spike is around the mid game. That's when you're strongest. So we'll see how true that is. I should be fine though if they do keep on pushing this. Because one thing that Ylva was good against was stopping people from pushing down your turret. That was when his strength evolved. Yeah, so if you just play around your Stormcrown proc, you can get a bit more true damage in. Instead of using it on a minion or something, if you could try and get on an enemy hero. I know Gromchaw's still here. Adagio is here too. I don't know about this one. I'm just trying to go for the Vox. Oh, nice, I stunned him out of his A. Yeah, I don't think there's any way that I can kill this Gromchaw. Ooh, actually, with Rhyme here, I can maybe win this. Can you get root? Nice. Okay, that was a good rotate. That was good. I don't really mind if he takes my farm much, because I'm utility, it's not a huge deal. Looks like I'm attacking myself. Nice, okay, see if you do land the burst, you do get some nice amount of damage. I'll show you around. Just don't... Oh, so it's gonna keep us from pushing in the wave. Wait, actually, can we kill him here? Oh, he's still at Fountain. Wait, I don't know if that was the move. Oh, wait, what am I doing? I can't catch up to that. I thought he was gonna stand underneath turret. Wait, if we kite back, if he walks onto the strap, we can turn onto this. I still have flask. Nah, I second. See, that is super strong. Kinda like that. Oh, we gotta watch out. That rhyme, is he good? Do I need to save him? Oh, okay, never mind, looks like he's good. Does he want this? No, looks like he's just recalling. It's fine. Be like, if you see a teammate rotating like that, you can try and start an engage early. Because a lot of times the rotate teammate, like, by the time they get there, if you start an engage, then it's just much easier to get the kill. Let's see if we can get in a good rotate here. Because I can't exactly push that in. Ooh, maybe we can get the scarf. Yeah, you're not getting away from that. Oh, can we save this guy? Nice, okay. That's good. I can rotate back top now. That box is trying to push in the turret. Yeah, Ylva seems really strong for rotates though. Because if you can gank Boots getting one good combo, you can almost like guarantee a kill. I should be able to get this Vox here. Oh, wait, I think I accidentally canceled my stun. That's it. It doesn't matter. Okay. We got four of us here. We should do this. I need Gwen to rotate. Vampire Carrier definitely helped take this so much faster. Okay, let's see. Maybe I can get the scarf again. Can I get him? Nice. Oh, that Finn missed Fountain too? Yep, that's definitely not me. Okay, I think Gwen's got that. I'm gonna have to head back top. Yeah, these rotates are really nice on Ylva. You could just completely one burst a carry, almost. Oh yeah, that's a strong combo. The slow from Adagio plus the root from Rhyme. Plus you can get Rhyme ulted too. They've had really good rotates this game. I definitely think that our team is playing really effective. This is kind of what the meta was before, since for junglers, it's not too effective to rotate top lane, because the only reason why you'd be on top side of the map is to take the two back doubles behind the CP buff. Since the jungler normally doesn't take the CP buff, so if you rotate to top side just for the back doubles and then you go top, it just slows down your rotation so much more since you don't get to your gold oak and stuff as much. So normally what it is the jungler stays bot side and then the support and mid laner can rotate top, which is kind of what we're doing this game. It's working out really well. Because like, I don't think our junglers came top a single time and they've just been helping the bot lane. While mid and... Okay, sorry about that, guys. I got a phone call, so let's stop the recording for a minute. Okay, can head mid lane now. Okay, we are still recording. That is good. Ooh, maybe we can catch out this fox. Where did they go? Okay, they just popped Flask. Let's see, if I can get an A ability over this wall, I can maybe get someone. Okay, there's our fountain. So like, with one burst, you can make him waste so much. Just gotta watch out for the Finn hook. He might try and hook under your turret. I got Crucibles, though, so it should be fine. Okay, never mind. Looks like they're just gonna recall. I think we can get this turret here before they get back. Wait, let's see if we can get our pulsifs onto this box. Nice, okay. We did. Not gonna get a stun on someone. Oh no, he's one shot. Oh wait, the rhyme got him. Nice. Oh wait, I did not see that. That was way off my screen. Oh, the lag. Wait, I'm taking turret aggro. Oh, how is that taking turret aggro? Ah, sorry about that. Yeah, the recording's from before the phone call just saved. Yeah, that's one thing that sometimes annoyed me about playing on phone is your field of view is a little smaller, so it's harder to see, like, everything that's going on, so I couldn't exactly see the fin very well, so it makes it way harder to land some crucible sometimes. But yeah, it looks like we should be able to end. That's gonna be about it for this video. Thanks for watching. Make sure to like and subscribe if you have not. Drop a comment down below, anything that you want. And these are the builds. Thanks for watching, and I'll see y'all in the next video.